Aloha, good morning. This is part 5 of the lecture on 1C document or Ichiman Kishomo. Today, I have two apologies, and the one apology is that because I don't have any manuscript for this lecture, I sometimes say wrong thing and wrong information, and sometimes I miss the important parts, and sometimes, you know, I say too much. And the other day, I watched, you know, my YouTube, and in the beginning part, I said this is part 3, but after that, I said part 4. And so was, you know, I said sincere heart, and this is heart, you know, the kokoro should be translated heart. And after that, I said this is sincere mind. So maybe sometimes confusing, I have to apologize that. And another apology is that, you know, it may sound that I'm a very arrogant, you know, when I speak English. Especially for Japanese people, the person who speaks English, you know, sounds very arrogant. And the other day, I was watching the YouTube that, you know, young minister from Japan was speaking, talking about Dharma talk. And then he was very good at English. However, he sounded like very arrogant. And I thought, you know, this may be because of, not from the personality, but from the fact, you know, speaking English. So the language, as compared to, you know, Japanese language, English, you know, you need confidence. You need to state, or you need to make it very clear whether you are affirmative or negative, yes or no. And then, you know, as a sentence structure, subject always comes. And without subject, you cannot talk. And then next part is a very important part, that verb comes. So, in the very short sentence, in the very beginning part, we have to express your statement very clearly. That is English structure. On the other hand, Japanese sentence structure is very not clear. Ambiguity is a characteristic of Japanese language. So, subject is sometimes, and often in many cases, omitted. Subject omitted, and the very important part, which is verb, come in the end. After so long, you know, alba, you know, da 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 da, and then coming. And sometimes, you know, the verb is not clear, like maybe. And then we Japanese people like to say maybe. And then this maybe is not sure, maybe yes or maybe no. And then we just say maybe. So this is because of the language. And so, as a characteristic of Japanese speech, we often start with apology. Oh, you know, thank you for the opportunity. I'm very honored. However, I don't have enough knowledge. You know, I'm not, you know, that kind of quality. I don't have. Or apology that, you know, I'm sorry, my English is not good. So always, not always, but many cases, start with apology. And by making apology, you know, we have something to share. So why Japanese, you know, very modest or have to express apology in the very beginning part is, I think this way. And I have very interesting explanation. So the, you know, the speech, the speaker is like teacher, right? And the speaker is usually one. And audience is many people, usually. So this is like a speaker is teacher. And then, as is often the case with speech, the speaker speaks from one step up. So looking down to the audience, this way. And the audience is look up to the, you know, speaker. So this structure is actually not good because of Japanese value. What values the best is we call harmony. Harmony, what is called, we call wa or yawaragi, this kind of. Harmony should be valued the highest. So this speaker, the relationship between speaker and audience is not good from the viewpoint of harmony or peace. Or, you know, what is harmony, peace, and the sense of togetherness. Sense of togetherness. So, from the viewpoint of harmony, you know, the difference between speaker and audience, not good. There is a huge, huge gap between the relationship between speaker and audience. So, in order to get rid of the, you know, gap, in order to become one in harmony, speaker needs to step down. Step down. How? This is apology. So in the very beginning part, by apology, making apology, or sometimes the expression of modesty. Expression of modesty. By doing that, the speaker and audience can become one. So this is all depending on, I mean, because of harmony is valued. So another very interesting example is that when we Japanese go to restaurant as a group, which food to order is very difficult. It's always difficult. Here in the United States, you can order whatever you want to eat. Oh, this is, you know, the chicken, wild chicken. Okay, go, go. Sorry. Anyway, you know, we go to restaurant. You know, here in the United States, we order whatever we want to eat, right? However, Japanese, because of harmony, sense of togetherness is very important. So we order depending on who orders, and you know, we have to adjust. We have to see the balance of the group. That is, of course, we never think, but this is actually automatically and naturally thinking, always, you know, natural. So, for example, as a group, we go to restaurant and the boss or the leader or the sponsor, you know, who treats the food, order hamburger. Oh, he order hamburger. This means I cannot order ultimate hamburger. So, you know, depending on who ordered, so he ordered hamburger, I cannot order, you know, ultimate lobster. Oh, no, yeah. So, and then if he ordered ultimate cheeseburger, oh, okay, that means I can order too. So, something like that. Actually, we don't think, this is naturally think. So, because of harmony. Okay, so sometimes if the leader, actually, you know, the leader or boss or sponsor, because I'm a priest, so priest is very generous, so always say that, okay, you can order whatever you want. So this is another harmony that, you can order whatever you want to eat, is this is just like the speaker step down, very you know, high people. Okay, you know, you can order whatever. That is depending on harmony. And, you know, we order depending on order. So this is kind of culture. So, you know, because harmony or peace or togetherness is so important, so the English language sounds very arrogant. And the reason why harmony is valued was because Buddhism was imported to Japan about 538 Buddhism came, was transmitted to Japan, and after that, maybe 50 to 60 years later, the Prince Shotoku, he was a prime minister, like prime minister, regent, and then Prince Shotoku, it is said that made 17 articles of constitution, the first time constitution in Japan, about 600 something, the first time constitution, and the number one sentence of the constitution is, wa omotte, wa, 和らぎを持って立っときとなす。和を持って、you know, the harmony. 立っときとなす。Should be respected highly. Should be respected highly. Harmony is to be valued. To be respected the highest. 立っときとなす。So, because of the constitution with influence of Buddhism, the harmony has been the main part of Japanese culture. So, harmony and Buddhism are so related. And because we value harmony, we like to belong to majority. We like to belong to majority. You know, we are independent and individual. We are all different. But because harmony is valued so much, we sometimes need to sacrifice or belong to majority. And this is harmony is good. If everybody is facing good, if everybody is trying to be good, the harmony works good. However, there was a time that the harmony didn't work. That was World War II, the war, the invasion of, I don't want to say any political, but there was a time that harmony didn't work. So there must be some people, who didn't like war. Of course, actually, not some people, but many people, but the many, the majority of the top of Japan was going to face the war. Everybody, majority of people couldn't say no. That was the bad influence of harmony, didn't work. So we have to be careful. But now, because of American influence, so many, European influence, world is getting be more exchange of culture, exchange of influence. We are more like American, more like American. So anyway, I'm talking about what? Yeah, you know the speaking of apology. We say, すみません, right? すまない, for meaning apology. And すみません also means thank you. So, すみません or すまない means both thank you and apology, I'm sorry. And this is complicated, but the Chinese word, xie xie. This is a kanji for xie xie, and xie xie means thank you, right? xie xie. And xie means actually apology. So, although xie xie means thank you, but originally or literally means apology, means thank you. And how do we understand apology as a thank you? I think this is very deeply rooted with Buddhism. In order for us, for human beings to live, we have to take other forms of life. Sometimes people say, oh, I'm vegetarian. I'm not taking other forms of life. So he indicates that other forms of life equal like meat, pig, cow, fish. We don't eat. We are vegetarian, we are clean. However, vegetables and tomato, cucumber, eggplant, they are all vegetable, other forms of life. They are life too. It's kind of destiny we, in order for human beings to live, we have to take other forms of life. And if we are really mindful of this fact, this is nothing but apology. I'm sorry, for the tomato. I'm sorry for the cucumber. I'm taking your life. And I'm sorry for fish. You must have a good life. But in order for us to live, we need to eat. I'm sorry. And this sense of apology must have become thank you. So, you know, how each language, what kind of expression of thank you each language has? Previously, I made a YouTube about the thought of appreciation. So, if you are interested in that, please watch, you know, the expression of thank you. So, all different, you know, language has its own expression of appreciation. Like here in Hawaii, we say mahalo, mahalo. And then Japan, arigato, and arigato gozaimasu, thank you. So they are all translated equal, you know, the words of appreciation. However, originally and literally, they have their own unique meaning. So that I wanted to say. And so another apology that I almost forget is because, you know, I don't have any manuscript that, you know, I may, this series may be long and maybe sometimes maybe finish all of a sudden. I don't know. I'm sorry. So I want to apologize for that. So anyway, what we are now doing is that Shishu, the four modes of practice. So I want to, again, the original, you know, Hōden Shōnin wrote. And this is actually, Yōgi Mondo is the record of conversations between Hōden Shōnin and disciples. It is said that Yōgi Mondo is a record of the conversation between Hōden Shōnin and disciples. So there is a question answer. There are question answers. And this is, you know, the talking about Shishu is a question. と、信心の要は受けたまわりぬ。行の次第、いかが候ろうべきか。So, 信心の要は受けたまわりぬ。I have understand. You know, 信心 which is faith, or 安心 or three minds. So, okay, we understand. We have understand 信心 the faith. Then, 行の次第 Okay, then practice. What kind of attitude should we have?What kind of attitude should we have? What kind of mode of exercise should we have? This is a question by the disciple. And kotaru is an answer of the master, Master Hōden. Shishu wo koso hon to surukoto ni te sōrai. Okay? As for the attitude, the mode of practice, shishu wo koso hon to surukoto ni te sōrai. So there are four modes of practice. Hitotsu ni wa jōjishu.ないし、四つには無用種なる。So, the other day, I wrote the way of Shishu, like 苦行種 first. And, I think 無用種、無権種、常時種。And so, this Yogi Mondo, this is the way, 常時種 first, 苦行種 first, 無権種 first, and 無用種。But other writing, you know, the order was 苦行種 first, 苦行種 first, 苦行種。So, this is depending on the order. 常時種。一つには常時種。And, ないし、四つには無用種なる。This is the order I follow. 一つには常時種というは、前道は命の終わるをごとして誓って中止せざれという。So, this one, 法然上に quoted Master Shantao, 前道。前道大師 said, you know, until you come to end, until you die, at the last moment,誓って中止せざれという。Do not stop. Once you start the 念仏, do not stop. Do not abandon. Do not quit. So this is the meaning of 常時種, the lifetime long. And 二つには、苦行時というは、極楽の仏法奏法において、常に憶念して尊重をなすなり。So 二つに、苦行時というは、極楽の苦行種 is actually, has five kinds of 苦行種. So it is said that it's in the 西方要決. 西方要決 is a Master Jion about the almost same age of the Zen Master Shantao. And Master Jion's Saifo Yokes, it's written. Kugyoshu, so I'm quoting. これには五種がある。一つには縁のある聖人を敬う。二つには縁のある仏像と教えを敬う。三つには縁のある良き導き手を敬う。四つには縁を同じくする仲間を敬う。五つには参謀を敬う。とあります。So, according to the Jion's 裁縫要決。So, 苦行種。念仏 in reverence. To reverently and respect 念仏 has five kinds of 苦行種。That is number one, 聖人を敬う is to respect saints. Number two, 縁のある仏像と教えとを敬う。This is to respect statue. So everything respect. Ne? So five kinds of 苦行種 is everything to respect what? So to respect saint and respect Buddha statue and sutras.And number three is 良き導き手を敬う is a teacher. We call 全知識 the good knowledge, the teachers. And number four is 縁を同じくする仲間を敬う is co-workers, co-practitioner or companies, friends.So to respect friends, 念仏 friends, no, together we going. So respect each other to friends. And number five, 三宝を敬う three treasures. Three treasures. So this five is a content of 苦行種念仏 in reverence.And one of the, you know, very interesting of five is to respect saints. And Jion Shonin, the Saint Jion, continued. 一に縁のある聖人を敬うというのは、日常の企業動作のすべてにおいて、裁縫からそらすことなく、唾を吐き、代弁をするのにも裁縫に向かっては、してはならないというのである。So this is very strict, you know. Always respect West. Always respect West. And do not shishi to the West. And you know, one of the popular 法然上人 students, there is a Rensei.And Rensei was originally warrior, the samurai, the fierce samurai, you know, reckless samurai. It was called that, we call Rensei. The very famous samurai, you know, reckless samurai. But after, you know, he regret what he did, kill to the young samurai, He became one of the students of the 法然上人. And then, Rensei knew the 苦行種, learned 苦行種 from master. And that since he knew the 苦行種, he always respect the West. So from Kyoto to Kanto, he went. And actually, he,When he moved, that is from, I think, Kyoto to, he going to, sorry, confusing, I'm thinking of a Japanese map, and then, he was going to east, right? He was going to east, you are trying to go into the East. So that means if you are going to the East, you are back face to West. You are back face to West. So Renzi thought that disrespects the West. So when he went to East, when he went to West in the East, so he turned back and he faced, you know, the West and ride up on the horse. So this is the way he went because of the respect of the West. Renzi never faced, you know, tried back face to the West. No. Always try to face to the West. That is his expression of respect. But there is a very interesting, sorry, according to my wife, I always say very interesting, very important, and very good. I always use that, but this means, you know, I don't want to talk not very important, right? I want to talk very important, so that's why I'm talking. So, you know, oh, you always say very important, you have very poor vocabulary, but I don't want to talk about not very important. So that's why I said very important. So anyway, so the respect West. What is respect West is very interesting. So the other day, I said that Eko Hotsuganshin, explained Eko Hotsuganshin. And Eko, this is for kanji echo. So old days, this kanji is written, but I'm explaining this modern kanji, e, because meaning. And e means to turn. So this came from like turn. The shape of turn becomes this kanji. The interestingly, if you turn this kanji, so this kanji consists of two books, two squares. So one big square and inside there is a smaller square inside. And if you turn this kanji 180 degrees, just imagine, yeah, turn and still same. And another turn, maybe 90 degree turn and still same. So no matter how turn, this is same kanji. And on the other hand, this is ko. So this is e ko. Right? And the ko looks same. So this is smaller square, right? Smaller square. And the difference is this side is open. This side is open. And there is that over here. There's a line. So this means, you know, one side open means facing one place. So this means facing one place. So that is a, we call echo. And the ko, this kanji, later we come, it's coming in the Ichimaiki Shomo later, the important part. ただ一向に念仏すべし。ただ一向に念仏すべし。is. So this 一向、ただ、pronunciation is 一向。ただ一向に念仏すべし。This means to face, right? So facing one side. So what is this kanji, one line is means one. So one direction, okay, to the one direction you recite nembutsu. Tada ikkō ni nembutsu subeshi is you should recite devoutly, you know, concentrically, and one directly recite. That is ikkō. And so this means face. So what is echo is, you know, easy to understand if we offer incense. And, you know, we offer incense to the Buddha. However, who can enjoy the fragrance of incense? It's us. The person who offer incense. We offer incense to the Buddha, but at the same time, we enjoy the fragrance of incense. So this means, just like to Tan, we offer to Buddha, but Buddha also offer the fragrance of incense. This is echo. So another offering is like offering of light. We offer light as a wisdom to Buddha, but the light light up the room, the hondo. And this is, we think of Buddha, you know, offer the light. And the Buddha also offer the light. So this is just like whatever you do for the Buddha, Buddha respond. Just like to Tan, and no matter how Tan, it coming back to you again and again. So this is the meaning of echo. So what I want to, the interesting is still going on, the echo is the temple structure. When the temple is built originally, so to respect West, to respect West is very valued, because you cannot disrespect of the, you know, West. So that's why when the temple was built, they carefully, you know, decide the direction, and they place Buddha to the West. So the direction, we put Buddha to the West, so that when we pray, we offer, you know, a prayer to Buddha, that means we respect, we can always respect Buddha. So that means the Buddha altar is West. So that means altar West. And the entrance, this is entrance, sorry, this is my image of entrance. So that means entrance is facing east. So this is the very traditional, like we call Jodo style structure, temple structure. Jodo Yoshiki is always the Buddha in the west and entrance east. So this temple structure, actually to respect west, is same as structure of Christian church. So Christian church, when the church is built, they face east, they try to face east, and altar is west. And so the entrance east and altar west, that we call orientation. So orient is east. So to face the building, to face the building east, toward the east, is the meaning of orientation. And I understand this orientation comes from the belief that Jesus was coming back from the earth, revival of the Jesus Christ. He came with sunlight. So just before the sunrise, you know, from the dawn, he was there. And with light from the east, he was coming. So that's why east, facing the church, facing east means the light coming, the light Jesus coming. That is the kind of meaning I understand. So this entrance east and altar west is exactly same as, you know, Buddhist temple, west altar and this entrance. However, nowadays, you know, because of the location and convenience, you know, not always like this temple, the east and west are completely different. But traditionally, to respect west is because it says, you know, Saiho Yoketsu is very traditional respect of the west. That's why the temple is built like this. So anyway, I want to continue. Mukenju. Mitsu ni wa mukenju to iu wa yōketsu ni iwaku. Tsune ni nenbutsu shite oujō no kokoro o naze. Issai no toki ni oite kokoro ni tsune ni omoi takumu beshi. So, tsune ni nenbutsu shite. Okay, all the time nenbutsu and oujō no kokoro o naze. Okay, and this is like oujō suru zo to omou jini. Like, I'm going to be born in the pure land. And that one, to have the mind to understand I'm going to be born in the pure land. This is mukenju. And issai no toki ni oite is all the time. And to continue to recite Namu Amida Butsu. That is mukenju. Yotsu ni wa muyoshi というは、妖結に曰く、もはら極楽を求めて弥陀を来念するなり。来念するなり。そう、無用紙というは弥陀を来念するなり。そう、無用紙 is, you know, not other Buddhas, but Amida Buddha. Your prostration and 念仏。That is,Muyoshu, no miscellaneous practice, but the right practice to say, to recite Namu Amida Butsu. That is Muyoshu. Sorry, I'm not good at you know, explaining this shishu, so I want to come back, you know, set time, you know, another opportunity to explain, because you know, we have very nice book of lecture on Senchakushu. This is written by Archbishop Todo Kyoshun Sensei. So this is a very good book. So I want to introduce maybe memo or whatever understanding, interpretation. So this is very good. Like it says that, you know, 師匠の中で一番大事なのは無見種なんです。So 東堂先生 said that, you know, during the four of the, you know, 無見種, no, 師匠, the four modes of practice, 無見種が一番大事なんです。Is the 無見種 is the most important. And,ですから無見種はただ申しましたように念仏をずっと継続し続けるということ、形式から言えばそういうことになります。あ、ハロー、イエス、いや、それOkay, so, so, Todo Sensei, that the 一番大事なのは無見種、無見種、you know, no interval, 念仏, you know, in continuity, 念仏 is in there. So, that means to continue 念仏 and, you know, お念仏を絶え間なく申し続けるというその中身を考えてみると、お念仏というものは阿弥陀仏とお念仏を唱える私との関わりなのです。ですから、お念仏を申せば、唱えるほどその関わりが深まり、途切れることがなくなるんですね。This is very deep. He says that, you know, the mukensho, to recite nenbutsu is a relationship between Amida Buddha and me, myself. So, to recite nenbutsu, you know, in continuity, we strengthen the bond, the strengthen the relationship between Amida and myself. And the more we decide, we recite, the more stronger the relationship become. So this is the relationship Mukenshu is talking. And Mukenshu indicates Nenbutsu in continuity means by reciting in continuity, we can make stronger the relationship between Amida and myself. So this reminds me that the last time Mukenshu is, you know, Muken, you know, in continuity with us, no, you know, ceaseless continuity. So all the time means like common sense, like call me. And when person says, call me anytime. And this means he doesn't have any specific time. Like he doesn't, you know, indicate this is 2 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning. But the feeling is that anytime okay. Like it's accept, no, anytime accept. The feeling is accept anytime, but the word call me anytime, he doesn't think of 2 o'clock in the morning and 4 o'clock in the morning. So this, by making, you know, relationship, the stronger the relationship means we can call anytime. Because if the relationship is like parent and child, child can always call parent anytime. And parent don't mind to call the child anytime. It's for sure anytime. For sure anytime, anytime. So this what, you know, Mukenshu wanted to say that, you know, recite Nenbutsu anytime, anywhere. Anytime, anywhere is just like strengthen the relationship between Amida and myself. So let me quote the Nakamura Sensei's translation. So number 14. We have discussed faith and come to understand what it means to have faith in the Buddha. Could you now please instruct us on practice? The answer. The four qualities of practice set forth in Master Zendo's hymn in praise of the Pure Land should be considered the base of practice in the Pure Land path. The first of these is lifelong practice, which means to cultivate from this moment on, throughout life, without ceasing, until we die. The second is reverent practice. This is to practice devoutly, to be mindful at all times of the Buddha, Dharma, and the Sangha of the land of bliss, and to pay respect to them in accord with their true value. The third, ceaseless practice, is explained as follows, is essential for birth. At all times, continually recite the Buddha's name, fixing your mind on birth in the Pure Land, and throughout life, incessantly recollect it. Without allowing yourself to be distracted, direct your attention to rebirth. The last of the four is exclusive practice. With your whole heart, look forward expectantly to rebirth in the Pure Land. Worship and bear in mind the Buddha, infinite light, and don't think about anything else, nor perform any other spiritual practices. Just single-mindedly think over Amida Buddha. All these kinds of practice should be continuously maintained day after day. So this is all about Shishu. But if there is a translation of Saifo Yoketsu, you know, Saifo Yoketsu, it's more written, more detail and more example. So I want to another time explain about Shishu and also Sanjin one more time because it's so important. So anyway, we are now returning to the sentence of the Ichimaikisho Wanshi document. So far, you know, the number three, the third sentence, ただ往生極楽のためには南無阿弥陀仏と申して疑いなく往生するぞと思い取りて申す他には別の司祭相らわず。 So this is another long sentence. So 別の司祭相らわず is the main part. That is, there are no special detail necessary. So there are no special detail necessary.Except something. So except something. This part, except something, is that means very important. And for what is in order to be born, attain Ojo, to attain Ojo. So in order to be born in the pure land, this part.You know, except part is very important. That is to recite Namu Amida Butsu. To recite Namu Amida Butsu. And number two, no doubt. And number three, to understand. Actually, to recite understanding.In order to understand, to recite and to understand the belief. So to understand the belief, I'm going to be born in the pure land. So these three are very important.And actually significant is necessary. And it says that this is necessary. These are necessary. So, 南無阿弥陀仏と申して疑いなく申さない。And 往生するぞ。往生する。I'm going to be born in the pure land of Amida Buddha. 思い取りて、understand. 申す他には。And say,No special detail necessary. So that I said that. He said everything. Then he continued is because ただし. Okay, ただし. However. So however, okay, this is very simple. However, how do we understand the traditional idea? So ただし.However, Sanjin Shishu, と申すことの相応は、wrong, yeah. So, this sentence is actually very clear.As for Japanese, it's very clear to understand, and there is no other, you know, understanding possible. So, because 三人支出を申すことの相応は This is subject. 三人支出を申すことの相応は So, whenever you hear は like 私は、あなたは三人支出と申すことの相応は ただ往生極楽のためには So that は indicate this is subject. So we call this is subject marker. So this one は means okay this is subject. And so 三人師匠と申すことの僧侶 is subject.And this case, this one, you can take solo, because solo or sablo is, means nothing, and this means just to make it polite. This is polite. Like arimasu or de arimasu, right? So polite way and then it's addition.So this means you can take off. So the main part is 三人師主と申すことは三人師主と申すことは is you know, what is called? So 申すこと is what is told? What is called 三人師主は So that means と申すことは you can omit. So this is exactly talking about 三人師主三人師主 is something. This is a statement. What is 三人師主? So, ただし、however, 三人師主は And, you know, the verb comes in. And that is the verb part, main part, which is important. 三人師主は Okay, 三人 and 師主 is, what is? 子守僧侶なりSo this is the main part, verb, in the end. 三人師主と申すことの僧侶は皆欠場して南無阿弥陀仏にて往生するぞと思ううちに子守僧侶なり And so 子守僧侶なり is a verb. So that means So 三人師主 is included. Included is a It's a verb.そう、三人師匠と申すことの僧侶は皆欠場して南無阿弥陀仏にて往生するぞと思ううちに子守僧侶なり And so に思ううちに So 思ううちに子守僧侶なり is included where? So between三人師匠と申すことの僧侶は and 子守僧侶なり inside is where is included where 三人and 師匠 is included where 三人 and 師匠 is included this is like where and actually this sentence has two verbs so 三人師匠 isAnd number one verb, so this is actually number two verb. Number one verb is 欠場して So, 欠場して nowadays we call 決定 So, 三人師主 is set is one sentence. 三人師主 is settled or 三人師主 is decided.三人師主 are decided 三人師主 are set all in set that is number one and number two 三人師主 is included and where and again this is important 南無阿弥陀仏にて往生するぞ and again 往生するぞ I am going to be born in the pure land.Is included. So, 南無阿弥陀仏にて is by 南無阿弥陀仏にて南無阿弥陀仏 by 南無阿弥陀仏 OK? 南無阿弥陀仏にて is by 南無阿弥陀仏往生するぞ OK, I'm going to be born in the pure land 往生するぞと思ううちに is, you know, by understanding or by believing by 思ううちに by believing I'm going to be born in the pure land 三人四種 is included so ただし is however 三人四種と申すことの候は is の三人四種 is 欠場して is all set is all become one and settled 三人四種 is settledAnd where included? ナムアミダ仏にて by ナムアミダ仏 by ナムアミダ仏 This is very straight not by reciting ナムアミダ仏 or by recitation of ナムアミダ仏 very straight expression by ナムアミダ仏 okay? by ナムアミダ仏 and 往生するぞ and I'm going to be born in the pure landI'm going to be born in the pure land と思ううちに思ううちに is believing you know, believing, strongly believing this is just like where there is a will there is a way there is a faith there is goal so by Namu Amida Butsu and by belief that I'm going to be born in the pure land 三人四種is included. 三人四種 is included. So that is the sentence. And another maybe interesting idea is the word ただし. ただし is like however and it's like conditional, like provided. You know, okay, conditional means there could beexception or any sometimes restriction limited way or however as for sanjin you know however as for sanjin and shishin this is very limited way of excuse me sorry another visitor so anyway ただし三人四種と申すことの候は is so ただし is very conditional limited however and the pronunciation ただし is also the 漢字ただし and supposed to be ただし so this ただし is usually used but the pronunciation ただし meansRight. So this could be, I understand this way. This could be, you know, this is a right understanding of 三人四種. So 三人四種と申すことの候は、三人四種は南無阿弥陀仏にて、okay? 欠場して南無阿弥陀仏にて往生するぞと思ううちに子守候なり This is the right understanding of 念仏 So usually you know we tend to think after we attain 三人 three hearts and because without 三人 you cannot born in the pure landOkay, so Sanjin is, you know, attain and recite. But Honen Shoni idea is, if you recite by Namu Amida Butsu, by reciting Namu Amida Butsu, Sanjin is already included. So this is a great idea of Honen Shoni.